2, 3.
Speaking to journalists shortly after the launch on Friday yesterday, Mbarara Municipality Woman MP Rita Bwahika said the program is targeting to address the gaps young people in schools face, which include reproductive health-related challenges and poor personal hygiene. Bwahika called on the government to enhance the roles of school nurses to include friendly services and communication and go back to sexual education curriculum. She also asked religious leaders and other leaders to take on sexual education through their platforms.
That for in the curriculum and in the structure of schools, we need to enhance the roles of school nurses to include friendly services, friendly communication, for them to unpack these things without necessarily helping, waiting for from NGOs or waiting for a goodwill person like me to come and do it.
Dr. Dan Navasa, a specialist in reproductive health, also emphasized the need for adolescent sexual reproductive health programs to go in schools to address the gaps. He said there is also a need to involve the male students in the adolescent reproductive health programs, saying they are also largely affected like females.
I have observed that there is a need for adolescent sexual and reproductive health program in schools.
Anarisinsio Mutatina, the head teacher of St. Peter's SS Katukuru, called for a need to have deliberate programs by the Minister of Education to address some of the challenges students face.
I think there should be a deliberate program by government or by the Minister of Education to go down and educate the students, even the guardian and parents, about the problems these girls go through when they are in their menstrual period.
Some of the students we spoke to welcomed the program, saying it has come at a time when it is badly needed. They said many young people in schools face a lot of challenges and lack knowledge on how to go about them. Report by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news in Mbarara.